what's really incredible about the Jacobs School, especially the choral conducting program, is that we get all this experience. It's a luxury that you don't get anywhere else. We have these morning ensembles that we get to rehearse every day. Every day I'm in front of a choir, constantly preparing, and I'm constantly being able to experiment and try new things and see what does work and what doesn't work. I don't know of too many places that else you can do that.
Here we really learn how to go from an idea that is floating in the air to putting it in practice.
I love this school because it allows me to dream as big as I want.
We're very interested in the choral department at the Jacobs School in preparing conductors for what the next chapter in choral music might be. And we've tried to put together a faculty that represents various facets of the choral art as we see it developing in the future. We welcome to the faculties Dr. Stephen Zegree, Dominick DiOrio, Walter Huff, and Dr. Betsy Burleigh, who has had an amazing career in the choral orchestral repertoire, the large symphonic choral orchestral works, both conducting them herself and preparing them for others.
We're really excited that we're starting a new chapter here at IU. We have something to offer just about everyone, right? We have ensembles in a range of specialties, from early music to new music to contemporary popular music to opera. If you study here as a conductor, you get the opportunity to work in all of these genres and all of these fields with a faculty member who specializes in music of this time.
I will sacrifice anything somewhat might for the sake of having you near in spite of a warning voice. Comes in the night and repeats, repeats in my ear. Don't you know you're a fool?
I think what makes the Indiana University Choral Conducting program so unique and so wonderful as a great place for students to study is the fact that it's comprehensive. We want to prepare all of our conductors for a great career that causes them to have experience in all areas of the great tradition of choral music.
Now, nicht. One, two, three, four. Nicht. Good. One, two, three, da, da. Nicht. Yes.
I love potential. I enjoy seeing the potential in a student and immediately setting up an atmosphere to help them progress and succeed. There's a lot of podium time for conducting students. For my assistants in these operas, I've put them in front of the chorus. They're doing backstage choruses for me during the show. If I'm not here, if I'm traveling somewhere, it is their deal. I'm kind of looking at this IU choral faculty as one-stop shopping for a choral conducting student.
As a teacher, as an educator, I get really excited when I see a student get it. As a musician, you practice all the time. There's this point of frustration where you just want to get past something so badly, and you practice and practice, and then there's this moment, this aha moment of you get it, right? There's something where everything lines up, and seeing this moment in my students is one of the most exciting things of being an educator.
I learn every day from listening to concerts or being present in rehearsals or just by having coffee with my friends and discussing of some specific issues that are going on in our lives.
During the master's course of 2 years, we actually conduct symphonic choir. So we decide all the music we are doing and we do our warm-up and make seating plan, make concert program, and finally we have concert with the choir.
The opportunities are endless here, and I think that's very unique, and it's exciting to be able to, you know, wake up in the morning and thinking, what piece of music would I like to do, and be able to do it.
Come.
This is a great school of music for students who are really self-motivated and ambitious and who are able to take advantage of the incredible wealth of opportunities. We have an incredible student body of young musicians who will go on to be leaders in their fields in the future.